So let's continue. We have started the discussion already. Clear? Glimpses of India, part 2, Coorg. We are going to read about this smallest district, which is set between Mysore and Mangalore. This is the geographical location of this beautiful district, Coorg. Fine? It is also called Kodagu, the second name of this beautiful place. Then, it is situated in hilly area, hills. It's very pretty. And descendants of Coorg district, they are descendants of Greeks and Arabs, it is believed. Fine? They have inherited their, you can say, traits from Greeks and Arab people. Clear? So this is the just basic introduction of this chapter. Fine? Now we will be reading in detail and you will be writing some more points side by side. Clear? So keep your notebooks and pens with you and please open page number 90. I don't want to waste the time. Your exams are around the corner only. So we have to finish this chapter because we already started. Midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore sits a piece of heaven that must have drifted from kingdom of God. Why they are saying drifted from kingdom of God? Because it is very beautiful. It is so beautiful that it is considered as piece of heaven, that part of heaven. This land of rolling hills is inhabited by a proud race of martial men. Martial men, beautiful women and wild creatures. Who are martial men? Underline. It is written having to do with the war. The people who have to play important role in warlike circumstances, those brave people. So this place is not beautiful the way it looks. It is also beautiful the way the kind of people are residing in it. Okay? Martial men, beautiful women and wild creature. Wildlife is very famous of Coorg. I'll be asking the questions in between. And especially to those who are not at all concentrating. Clear? And if you are unable to answer, I have to set a meeting with your parents only. Exams are there. Pre-boards are going to start in the last of October. And still you people are very casual. Coorg or Kodagu, the smallest district of Karnataka. Underline this. Fine. The name of the state is Karnataka. So this Coorg district belongs to Karnataka. It is home to evergreen rainforests, spices and coffee plantations. So in abundance, what is found over there? Spices and coffee plantations. Evergreen rainforests cover 30% of this district. This chapter carries a lot of factual information. Fine, so many MCQs can be set up here. 30% rainforests cover this place. During the monsoons, it pours enough to keep many visitors away. So what happens when rainy season is there? People avoid visiting such place because of heavy rainfall. The season of joy commences. Commences means starts from September and continues till March. So September beginning, March end. So this time period is famous for the visits of the visitors or travelers. The weather is perfect with some showers thrown in for good measure. So it doesn't mean that during this season, rain won't be there. Yes, but it in that amount which can be accepted or which can be bearable by the people. People can visit. A few showers can be there. The air breathes of invigorating coffee. That is, vigor is had to do with the strength. So coffee is, when we intake coffee, this is considered that it gives you energy, boosts up energy. So they are saying that the air breathes. So you can smell the plantation of coffee that it is famous for. Coffee estates and colonial bungalows stand tucked under tree canopies in prime corners. So what is the casual or common scene over there? Canopies is a row of the trees. Fine, a lot of trees in a row they are standing. And beautiful bungalows can be seen under it. In every prime corner of this beautiful place, Coorg. the fiercely independent people of Kurg. Now, after discussing the geographical description, they are going to talk about, please ask him to sit straight. Please, beta. So now we are going to talk about the kind of people. Jo log hai, wo kaise hai wahan pe. Underline, the fiercely independent people. They are not dependent upon others. They are kind of people who are very dependent. But the people of Kurg are very energetic and smart. They do not depend upon others. They are possibly, this is not sure that they are descendants of Greeks and Arabs. Possibly, right? There is possibility that they are descendants of Greek and Arabic descent. As one story goes, now, very important part. Term one will be MCQ.
Yes.
Term two will be subjective.
Yes.
So you can prepare yourself accordingly. Clear? So of course, sab kuch aana chahiye. You know, ki some students have forgotten how to write. You have to keep the habit of writing also. So whatever question answers we will be discussing, you will be writing in your notebook also. They are going to discuss one story. This story, famous story hai. This is a kind of prevailing tale in the district of Kurg. So that's why people started associating ki achha iske descendants Arab and Greek se mein. Clear? So, story goes, I'm going to start that story. A part of Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled here when return became impractical. These people married among us the locals, and their culture is apparent in the martial traditions, marriage, and religious rites, which are distinct from the Hindu mainstream. Now, the question is, how do we get to know that Kurg people are considered descendants of Greeks and Arabs? Iska proof mang rahe hain. That how do we get to know ki wo jo wahan pe log reh rahe hain, that they belong to descendants of Greeks and Arabs. So it is known to people, the story prevails is that once a part of Alexander's army, they moved the south along the coast and they settled there in the district of Kurg. Okay. When one part of the army of Alexander, they settled there permanently, they got married with the women of the Kurg itself. Obviously, when the posterity or coming generation, jo kids the aage, to dheere dheere, jo kaun sa custom will be followed over there? Arabian and Greeks. So Greek and Arabian people already settled there, some part of Alexander's army, and they got married there, they had kids, and then coming generations, they started inheriting the traits of Arabs and Greek. This is the way. Is it clear to all? So how do we get to know? Because jo wahan ke men the, they started making the people follow the culture of unki jo religious ceremonies thi. Every child sitting in the class, they might have different religious ceremony performed at home. Some people believe in Lord Ganesha, some believe in Lord Shiva, some believe in Guru Nanak, fine. So everybody has a different set of religious ceremonies at home. Clear? And how do we get to know? Whatever your parents are following, obviously you are following, and coming generation follows, so on. So similarly, here, in the marriages and in the religious ceremonies, it was quite obvious that when they saw the traits and features of Arabs and Greeks, so then they came to the conclusion, okay, fine, that here people seem to be the descendants of, not all, but many people. Clear? The theory of Arab origin draws support from the long black coat with an embroidered waist belt worn by the Kodavus. Aapko pata lag gaya tha uska name? Kodagu bhi hai, state ka name. And second signal which we get from the people, do not disturb others, Dishant. Whosoever is doing, you should control yourself only. Don't give your brain in others' hands. So, the theory of Arab origin. Now, secondly, uska ek aur proof hai. Firstly, in the religious ceremonies and marriages, I'm going to ask you people now. Okay, you wait for your turn. Second story is, that theory of Arab origin draws support from the long black coat. They wear a particular dress. Their attire, their dressing sense is long black coat and उसके ऊपर वो एक एम्ब्रॉयडरी वाला वेस्ट बेल्ट डालते हैं एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड पीपल ऑफ दिस डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोडागु दे आर नोन एज कोडागुज फाइन कोडागु इज द नेम ऑफ द प्लेस जो वहां के रेजिडेंट्स थे उनको कोडागुज वी यू लास्ट में लगा दो अगर बाकी स्पेलिंग सेम है सो कोडागुज दे वुड वेयर अ पर्टिकुलर ड्रेस और ड्रेस का क्या नाम था It is Kupia, Kuppia, the black dress with embroidered belt. Okay, it resembles the Kufia worn by the Arabs and the Kurds. This is the second sign. Fine, I repeat those who are not paying attention. First sign kya hai? Their customs of marriages and religious ceremonies. They are the proof that they are descendants of Greeks and Arabs. Second sign is that they wear a black long dress with embroidered belt, which was worn by Arabian people. Restless boys in the class, restless. Mind is not at rest. Let's add more names into the list. I don't want to continue the way you behave. I'm speaking just because of the sake of the people who are listening. Half of the class is just coming for the sake of passing the time and setting their hairstyles. Nobody is waiting for you to laugh. Kurgi homes have a tradition of hospitality. Now, what sort of traits in the families? Firstly, I told you about the geographical place. Secondly, I discussed why they are called so and how they are known as descendants of Arabs and Greeks. Now, I'm going to talk about the hospitality. When you meet such people, what sort of personality they are? Kurgi homes. They have a tradition of hospitality, mehman nawazi jisko keh dete ho. And they are more than willing to recount numerous tales of valor. Valor means bravery related to their sons and fathers. So whenever you visit any Kurgi home, people will tell you the tales or stories of valor of their fathers, forefathers, grandfathers. Clear? So why? In the beginning, I told you that this place belongs to martial men. Because they have background of war and they have stories to tell, obviously. कि कैसे उनके forefathers ने war-like circumstances को win किया था. The Kurg regiment is one of the most decorated in the Indian army. Underline this, very important. Kurg regiment is one of the most decorated in the Indian army and the first chief of the Indian army General Karyappa was a Kurgi. Underline this also. Why Kurgis are famous in Indian Army? Because the first chief jo Indian Army ka bana tha, he belonged to Kurg only. His name was General Karyappa. Even now, Kodavus are the only people in India permitted to carry firearms without a license. To keep the firearms, such prohibited substance, like people carry guns, but they should have license. But if you have license, it doesn't mean if you have license, you will keep the gun in the pocket. No. If you're keeping it at home, some people in even Punjab, if they belong to some authority, they can have the license. It doesn't mean they have the access to use it. Fine. Similarly, Kurgis were so famous for their bravery and valor, and they're part of being present in the Kurg army, Indian army. Even now, Kodavus are the only people in India jinko permit hai firearms rakhna without a license. The river Kaveri obtains its water from the hills and forests of Coorg. Underline this. Kaveri River obtains its water from the hills of forests of Coorg. Mahaseer, a large fresh water fish. Underline this is the name of. ऐसे ही लोग होते हैं जो बाद में पूछते हैं फर्स्ट 21st का कौन सा आंसर है. नाउ दे आर नॉट लिसनिंग इवन. ए लगा दूं कि बी लगा दूं. चीटिंग की प्रिपरेशन करते हो और पढ़ाई की प्रिपरेशन जीरो है. एवरीथिंग इज बीइंग रिकॉर्डेड हियर इन द लेक्चर. आई एम गोइंग टू अनाउंस द नेम्स नाउ. एटलीस्ट 10 बॉयज ऑफ योर क्लास, नॉट अ सिंगल गर्ल. Continuously talking. And I'm very much serious. I'm going to inform the parents. I'll make a group of, I'll be writing it as naughty students of 10th D and parents will be added. Then they will get to know what you're doing in the class. I'll keep on updating with the name of the child, what, how you behaved in the class today. Then aapko sharam aayegi. Otherwise, aapko sharam aayi nahi rahi hai. A large freshwater fish, its name is Mahaseer, abound in these waters. So, kaun si fish bahut zyada paayi jati wahan pe? Mahaseer. Kingfishers dive for their catch, while squirrels and langurs drop partially eaten fruit for the mischief of enjoying the splash and the ripple effect in the clear water. Elephants enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mohots. Mohots कौन होती है जो elephants का ध्यान रखते हैं? They remain with them. The owners of those elephants. उनको mohot बोल देते हैं. Abound is in abundance. In this context. Fine. Where they have used this word? Abound in this water means here you can easily find this fish. Fine. Part of the waters, you can see. So, they are actually telling us about the wildlife of this place. The most laid back individuals become converts to the life of high energy adventure with river rafting. Kya kya available hai wahan pe? Most of the places which are very natural. These days, it is very much in trend that you can find all the water-based adventures over there or other adventures. So, what they have over there? River rafting, canoeing. Canoeing is also boating. Rappelling, meaning is given going down a cliff by sliding down a rope. Fine. Rock climbing, mountain biking. Numerous walking trails in this region are a favorite with the trekkers. Underline the games or facilities available. Birds, bees, and butterflies are there to give you company. Macaws, Malabar squirrels, langurs, and slender. Underline this, Princey. Macaws or macaws. I will find it. Okay, maine iska meaning nahi likha hua. Malabar squirrels, langurs, and slender lories keep a watchful eye from the tree canopy. I do, however, prefer to step aside for wild elephants. So these are the wildlife creatures found in abundance over there. The climb to the Brahmagiri hills bring you into a panoramic view of the entire misty landscape of Coorg. When you reach Brahmagiri hills, at such natural places, always vehicles are not available. There are some places where you have to trek only. So when you, after trekking, reach this place, you get a panoramic view. There are viewpoints, fine. In many, you might have traveled many places. So when we reach a particular point, we have the panoramic view, beautiful view of particular place. So they are telling us a walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64-acre island of Nisargadh. Running into Buddhist monks from India's largest Tibetan settlement at nearby Bailakapi is a bonus. The monks in red osher and yellow robes, that is orange color, Osher is that yellow, orange, and red color monks can be seen. They belong to Tibetan religion. Are amongst the many surprises that wait to be discovered by visitors searching for the heart and soul of India, right here in Coorg. So Coorg is also called heart and soul of India because this is very beautiful place. Then they have mentioned, beta, niche aap dekh sakte ho pink box mein fact file, how to reach Coorg. Fine, by air, by rail, by road. Clear? That you have to read on your own. Clear? That is just fact file is given to you. Now, let me ask you, those who are very, very attentive, no? Some points, firstly, aapne last point kaun sa likha tha? This one, Greeks and Arabs. I'd have some more value points into this for your preparation in the notebook where you were writing. Write down. People are brave, hospitable. People are brave and hospitable. Ye facts jo hai, chapter se related hai, that you should remember. The data you have to cram only because it's just memory based chapter. It's not that there is some theme and all. This is just the beauty of Coorg they have depicted, okay? The rest of the things are factual only. Brave and hospitable. That they treat others in a very nice way. Hospitable means jo apne guest ko welcome karte hai acche se. Hospitable. Then, Coorg regiment is one of the most decorated in Indian Army. Coorg regiment is... Coorg regiment is one of the most decorated in the Indian Army. Why it is called so? Because that you can tell the first chief of Indian Army was from Coorg. His name was General Karyappa. Clear that you have to remember in the chapter itself is written. River Kaveri gets water from the hills of Coorg. River Kaveri gets water from the hills of Coorg. A fish, Mahaseer, abounds in this water. Next point is a fish, Mahaseer. Spelling you can see in the book itself. Mahaseer abounds in its water. Abounds in its water. Then next you can write about the sports. Coorg is famous for river rafting. Coorg is famous for river rafting. Rock climbing, canoeing or traveling in a boat, you can write. Canoeing. C-A-N-O-E. Canoe ka matlab kya hota hai? Boat only. C-A-N-O-E-I-N-G. Canoeing, etc. The entire Coorg can be seen. Yes, Parikshit? River rafting. Last point, beta, the entire Coorg can be seen by climbing Brahmagiri Hills.